Have you ever admired the beauty of handmade pottery and wondered what went into creating it? How did a lump of soft clay become a rock-hard vessel with a colorful, glassy surface? The Greater Lansing Potters Guild has been creating works of ceramic art for almost 50 years at our studio in Haslett, Michigan. This video will provide a glimpse into the many steps involved in creating pottery, from the making of clay to the final firing of finished pots in our high-fired gas kiln. Clay and glazes are formulated from a large variety of raw materials. The Potters Guild purchases these materials in bulk from sources throughout the United States and the world. To make clay, dry powdered clay is mixed with wet, recycled clay using a paddle mixer, extruder, to obtain a firm mix with the right moisture content. The clay is then processed through the deaerating pug mill to remove air and thoroughly blend the clay. The clay logs are bagged and ready to use. The potter begins by wedging the clay to make it more plastic and to remove any remaining air pockets. Now the clay can be transformed into an endless variety of forms and shapes on the potter's wheel to make functional pots. Alternatively, the slab roller or extruder can be used in hand building or to make sculptural pieces. The clay can be stamped, cut, stretched, paddled, folded, sculpted, and manipulated in countless ways by the potter. After partial drying, the pot is ready for trimming, altering, or adding attachments to obtain the desired form and function and make the work unique. After several days, when the clay is completely dry, it is ready to be bisque fired. Pieces are carefully stacked in the bisque kiln, fired to a temperature of 1850 degrees, and allowed to cool, all over a span of 4 days. Once bisqued, pieces are ready for glazing. Guild members mix and formulate their own glazes in the studio. Ingredients are precisely measured and mixed, slaked into water to ensure hydration, and then sieved to remove undispersed particles. Once the proper consistency is obtained, the glaze is ready to be applied. At any one time, the Guild has over 40 glazes available for decorating pots. When used in combination, the color palette is expanded to hundreds or even thousands of different colors and textures. Glaze is typically applied by pouring, dipping, spraying, brushing, and other methods. Wax resist, slip decoration, and scratching and etching are also used to create unique and interesting designs. After glazing, the pottery is ready for the final firing in the glaze kiln. Pots are stacked carefully in the kiln with hardly an inch of wasted space. The kiln is preheated overnight before firing to a final temperature of nearly 2300 degrees. After cooling for 3 days, the kiln is opened and the long process of producing high-fired ceramics is complete. The culmination of all this work is the Guild Pottery Sale, held twice a year in East Lansing, where the public can view and purchase the incredible work of the Greater Lansing Potters Guild.